Good afternoon, race fans. Rick Eshelman with the World of Outlaws Morton Buildings Late Model Series. We are at the place they have known for a long time as Don Martin's Lernerville Speedway. We're here for the 13th annual Firecracker 100. 46 World of Outlaws drivers in attendance tonight for this 13th annual edition, paying $30,000 tomorrow night. Format very simple. A and B qualifying group split in half, 23 in each group. We'll run four heats, eight laps. We'll take the top four to the Morton Buildings feature. Two 10-lap last chance showdowns, taking the top three. The final two starting spots tonight for the 24-car field and just 30 laps and $6,000 to win. We'll have 24 cars starting. We're here in Lernerville. The king of Lernerville the last 2 years is going to join us now from Sarver, Pennsylvania. We're talking none other than to Michael Norris, normally in the 72. We'll talk about the 02 car he's in tonight. 10 years of experience, two-time and defending Lernerville Speedway track champ in the dirt car late models. All right, Mike, first of all, congratulations on your two track championships, but you raced with us down south in this February in the 72, your family car. Let's talk a little bit about the 02 you're in.
Well, the opportunity just came about from a good friend, Brian Dougherty. We kind of got really tore up at the Dream, and then we got tore up here the next day, and scrap prices being down and everything, it came at the right time. And we've kind of got a good relationship with Todd, and Brian's working on it, and we got Mark Saul as the crew chief, so I'm hoping it's going to be a good weekend.
Yeah, and you're talking about a lot of components that come to fit into the World of Outlaws over the years. You talk about Brian Dougherty, Integra Shocks, a contingency sponsor with the World of Outlaws along Kaiser Manufacturing. He's had a lot to do with us having races out west in Michigan before. You talk about Mark Saul, crew chief of the only one-time winner, Patrick Sheltra, who won at the Lawrenceburg Speedway back when Lawrenceburg had the old configuration. So you tie all them together, you got a veteran crew chief. You know this place as well, if not better than anybody. You're in a good car, so the combination, even though it's a little bit odd and pieces were put together, I think it's going to work.
Yeah, I hope so. Like I said, we're still working some bugs out. We shook the car down last week, and did pretty well. We had some things we still need to address, but I'm feeling pretty confident, like you said, having all those guys in my corner, especially then, you know, combining all them guys with my crew and my dad and every, you know, I'm hoping it goes well.
About time to pick up the Firecracker 100. They'll burn this place down if you go to Victory Lane tomorrow night. First of all, good luck tonight.
Thank you. Thanks for having me and for putting the race on.
Two-time track champion Michael Norris, not a shoe-in to get into the show, but definitely one of those drivers that's probably going to be there. Who knows? Maybe tomorrow night he walks away with one of the biggest crowns in all of World of Outlaws racing.